Hi, my name's Shawful, and welcome to another one of my videos where I talk about the world of data. In today's video, I'm going to talk about what's the first machine you should buy as a data scientist. So what kind of laptop do you need to do your work? Okay, so whether it's buying it itself or your company's buying it for you, what kind of specifications do you need for a laptop? Now, in this video, I'm not going to cover off what are the best laptops. I'm going to wait until some of the newer models come out in 2021, and then I'll sort of have a look at them and give you my opinion on them. But in terms of minimum specifications, if you need a laptop, what laptop do you need? Okay, so the first thing you should think about is RAM. Okay, how much RAM do you need when you're doing data science projects? Okay, so my recommendation would be you need something with at least 16 gigabytes of RAM. Okay, you can get away with 8 gigabytes of RAM, but I find you will struggle. Okay, so if you can afford it and you have the budget, I would go for 8 gigabytes of RAM. Okay, if you can go for more, that's brilliant, but if you could ideally stick to 16 gigabytes of RAM, okay, minimum 8 gigs, okay, but so don't go any lower than 8 gig, because then you would definitely struggle. Nothing will pretty much run, if you're, especially when you're working with sizable data sets. So try and stick to 16 gigabytes of RAM, okay? The next thing is obviously how much hard drive space you need, okay? So if you are looking at a hard drive, you should ideally look for SSD drives, or I mean, you know, you can stick to a normal hard disk, but if you go for an SSD drive, then I would recommend at least 512 gigabytes of RAM, hard disk, SSD hard disk, okay? Because you need a fast read-write sort of speed, especially if you're reading in data, saving it, and running sort of lots of analysis on that data set. If you can afford 1 terabyte of SSD drive, then that's great, but at least go for 512 gigabytes of SSD drive. If you can't afford an SSD drive, then go for a normal hard drive at 1 terabyte, okay? So that's sort of RAM and hard drive. The next thing is obviously your processor, okay? So what kind of processor should you go for? Ideally, always go for the latest generation of processor, whether it's Intel or Ryzen, okay? And try at least get quad core. Most of them now are quad core, but you know, there are still dual core processors out there. So you wanna aim for something like a Ryzen 5 or above, or an Intel i5 or above, okay? I typically try and buy Intel i7 processors, especially the latest generation. And you'll find it makes a big difference, because the faster your processor, obviously, the faster you can analyze data, and so you're not waiting around for things to sort of crunch away. So yeah, so try and aim for, you know, like I said, an i7 or a Ryzen 5 or above quad-core processor if you can. If you can't, an i5 processor's fine, but again, try and make sure it's a quad-core processor. Okay, and then finally, the sort of screen size. Okay, so if you've got a laptop and you will need to carry it around, obviously the bigger the screen size, the better it is for analysts. That's why sometimes we have multiple screens. But a 17-inch screen for a laptop is a bit too large. So I would recommend a 15-inch screen. Okay, again, a 15-inch is okay to carry. It still gives you a bit of weight on the laptop. If you find that you're carrying it around a lot and you don't want the weight, then maybe a 13-inch. Okay, I mean, that will do, especially if you're looking at sort of Excel sheets and a lot of data, you could probably get away with a 13-inch, but my recommendation would be to go for a 15-inch. So there you are. If you are looking for a laptop as a data scientist, look for something with, ideally 16 gigabytes of RAM, a minimum 8 gigabytes of RAM, a quad-core processor, you know, ideally an Intel i7 or a Ryzen 5 and above. You want at least 512 gigabytes of SSD drive. Anything more is great. If you can't do SSD drive, try and go at least for 1 terabyte of a normal drive, normal hard drive, and aim for a 15-inch monitor on your laptop. If you can't do a 15-inch screen, then 13 inches is fine, especially if you need to carry it around, and weight is quite important. Well, there you have it. Thank you very much for listening to my videos. If you have any comments, please do jot them down below. If you have any questions, also please ask them in the comments section. Please like this video, and of course, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.